हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 824 एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज द टॉक्सिक केमिकल वेपन्स एंड ऑलरेडी आई हैव डिस्कस लॉट ऑफ मिलिट्री एक्सप्लोसिव्स एंड नाउ दिस चैप्टर इज ऑन टॉक्सिक केमिकल्स एंड दिस टॉक्सिक केमिकल्स एक्चुअली globally, all the countries, they started manufacturing on mass scale, starting from World War I. And in April 1915, Germans, first time they used 600,000 pounds of chlorine gas in the area of more than 2 miles military enemy. And there were a lot of toxic effect, physiological effect, because chlorine gas can have your throat problem, lung problem, choking and tearing. So it started. And by 1945, there was thorough use of chemical weapons in World War I and World War II. And these chemical weapons are nothing but they are gunpowder, they are chlorine gas, they are mustard gas, they are ammonium nitrate, they are TNT, they are lead azide, ammonium chloride. All these were used during World War I and II. But later on it was realized that these chemical weapons, they have two negative factors. First factor, there is 80% loss, wastage. So there was big waste of money as well as chemical substance. And secondly, lot of innocent casualties were there once there is air current. So all the countries, every country was producing, but they realized that there should be some ban on these chemical weapons. So they met and they decided, but still today, many countries, they are holding lot of dangerous chemical weapons and they are in use. So here, the toxic chemical weapons, number one, toxic chemical weapons are those substances which produce powerful physiological effects. Powerful physiological effect means your lung will be affected, your liver will be affected, your throat will be affected, your whole anatomy and physiology, biology will be affected. And it is seriously toxic. It will make injury to your normal health. Screening smokes or defiant incendiary action by their chemical substances, that is called toxic weapon. And the use of these chemicals, begin in the World War I when incendiary and as far as sting substances were used in warfare. Fuxiating means that is what it is going to choke your lung and throat and nose, all even your nerve. So that was widely used in warfare. Number two. On April 22nd, 1915, the release of 600,000 pounds of chlorine gas along a 2 mile front against an unprotected enemy. So this is the serious issue, because where your enemies are camping, they are unprotected and you are using these chemical substances in the form of gas, in the form of smoke. And that was first time, it was on 22nd April 1915, 600,000 pounds of chlorine gas was released to the unprotected enemy. Similarly, many toxic gases were made and used, for example, chlorine gas, nitrocellulose, gunpowder, nitroglycerin, ammonium nitrate, trinitrotoluene, picric acid, अमोनियम पिक्रेट, टेट्राइल मरकरी, फुलमिनेट एंड लेड एजाइड. दीज आर ऑल ब्रांडेड केमिकल वेपन्स. इवन टूडे दे आर एग्जिस्टिंग, दे आर मैन्युफैक्चर एंड दे आर वाइडली यूज एज ए मिलिट्री एक्सप्लोसिव एज वेल एज ए केमिकल टॉक्सिक सब्सटेंस. नंबर थ्री, द यूज ऑफ द सो कॉल्ड पॉइजनस गैसेस इन वॉरफेयर इज वाइडली misunderstood because it should never be forgotten that to apply any toxic warfare chemical agents are always a great wastage of material. So here number four, the most important requirements of a toxic chemical are. So what are the requirements for a chemical to be toxic? And these conditions must be there. Otherwise, they will not be as effective toxic chemicals to be used in warfare. So A is, that is, it must be toxic, first thing, to man in very small quantity. Number, that is B, it should produce its effect regardless of how it enters the body, either as an inhalation or ingestion, that is in digestive system, or skin penetration. So these main three areas are there where it must affect. Either you inhale it through nose, it will go to lung, your throat, or it should go to your digestive system, digestion, or skin burn, that is, your skin must get it, the penetration. Now see, it should be difficult to protect against it. So once it is released, there should not be any method to protect from it. But let me give you one example. It was in 80s, I was there in LA, and my tanker was going, all of a sudden there was big noise and many people fainted because there was release of the gas, and it was panic. But as a chemist, I immediately understood, if any liquefied toxic chemicals are going, there are three possibilities. Either it will be hydrochloric acid, or it will be having chlorine, liquefied chlorine gas, or it will be having some ammonium nitrate, other substances. So ammonia can be released, hydrochloric acid can be released, chlorine can be released. And it was hydrochloric acid because I understood immediately. So I told them that don't be in panic. If any such situation comes, first thing is that you take your handkerchief or any cloth and put on your face, skin, with lot of water. So first thing is that how to dilute it, how to dilute its toxic effect. So hydrochloric acid, if it is in dry form, without humidity, without water, it cannot harm much. It can only harm your acidic impact once it will come in touch of water. With water it will release hydrogen ion and then it will burn. So immediately, what you do, you dilute it. Once it is hydrochloric acid with humidity, so you dilute it, its impact will not be there. So difficult to protect against. And D, its manufacture should be very cheap. Why we are not using much chemical weapons? Because it is having lot of wastage and its manufacture is costly. So unless it is cheap, because there is lot of wastage. And E, it should not react with or be decomposed by air, by water, and by any metal, or even by any earth material. So it should not decompose, and it should not react with any metal. F, it should be resistant to decomposition by any explosive shock. it should not decompose by any shock, by any explosive shock. And G, for ready dispersal over a wide range of environmental temperature, it is necessary to be volatile. So for all these toxic weapons, toxic chemicals, they must be volatile. Volatile means from liquid, from solid, directly they are changed into gaseous form, into smoke form. That is called volatility of the chemical. And H, it should also be easily liquefiable. So if it is solid state or gaseous state, it should immediately be liquefied so that easily it can be transported, be loaded easily. I, for chemical warfare, both volatile as well as non-volatile materials, solid that is dispersed as smokes, can be used. So, with this, I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.